I'm Rachel Haynes.
I'm Layla Guerrero.
And this is Bulldog Dispatch.
Some of the most overlooked staff members in our building are our lunch team.
These people take the time out of their day to prepare food for our students.
Sophia has more to discuss regarding our lunch staff.
We often take for granted the important work of our lunch staff here at Richards. After all, food has a huge impact on our school day. But this segment isn't about nutrition. It's about thanking the hardworking people who are behind the scenes in the lunchroom.
Mr. Evans gives us a rundown on his day-to-day tasks.
I have to make sure that the menus are all good to go. I have to make sure everything is hot, ready, and I always have to make sure that I'm in contact with our cooks. I also have to do safety inspections. I have to do safety calls. I have to do team meetings in the morning before the first lunch period, and just making sure that everybody is safe. Kids are good to go, okay?
Our cafeteria workers, they get here early, they stay late, they meet all of our needs for our building and our school community. Our cafeteria workers are here working hard to be sure that you students and our faculty get a breakfast and lunch provided to them. And in my opinion, they do it with aplomb and with a smile on their face.
I love conversating with the kids because they always keep me young. The kids, they always bring me joy, and especially when I can make sure that they're having the food that they want, and it's nutritionist as well, it's no better feeling.
I feel like the lunch ladies, they're very appreciative. Lunch man too, I love the food. They make sure they cook the food perfectly.
And they're always looking for ways to be a larger part of our Bulldog community.
Mr. Hamilton gives us insight on how they prepare all the food for each lunch period.
When I get here in the morning time, I set everything up. I start setting the food up by the time that each lunch period starts.
We have a system where we usually prepare 24 hours before, and it has to deal with the actual meats, some of the actual vegetables and fruits.
I just want to say thank you to those people, and I ask all of us to be a little kinder and a little nicer to them, and remember, they're a vital part of this learning institution, and we are more than lucky to have them.
For Bulldog Dispatch, this is Sophia Negrete.
As a celebration to AP students who passed at least one of their AP tests, our AP and EOS counselor, Ms. Talbert, distributed yard signs to show off their accomplishments.
Let's take a look.
Congratulations to all of our Bulldogs that earned AP college credit. Every spring, our students take AP exams that culminates all their learning throughout the year. And they can earn 3, 4, 5 on the test, which can also get them college credit. And we're just so proud of their hard work. So we decided to acknowledge them with yard signs this year. And we just want to encourage them to continue to do their best in our AP classes and just work as hard as they can. Well, this past year, we had over 200 students earn college credit. This year, we want to see that number go up. We are encouraging students that don't traditionally take AP courses to sign up for an AP class, especially if you're planning to go to college. The courses will help you to be more successful. So we're just encouraging our students to challenge themselves and to sign up for an AP class. You can actually earn college credit.
Deciding on a homecoming dress is hard.
Taya and Miracle visited That Girl Boutique and made some of those tough decisions.
Tune in to This or That. You can get with this or you can get with that. You can get with this or you can get with that. You can get with this or you can get with that. Do da dippity.
Welcome back to This or That. I'm Taya.
And I'm Miracle.
Let's go dress shopping.
My two favorite dresses was definitely the white and the black one.
My two favorite were the green and the black one. I really like the white dress on you. I feel like it complimented your skin tone and it just like really made it pop out.
Thank you. And for me, I like both of them, but I definitely like the black one more.
I also like the black one more. I feel like it just gives like that model type of look, you know, compared to the green one. That's why I also like your white one, because it just kind of gives like that Hollywood vibe to it, you know.
Thank you.
For Bulldog Dispatch, I'm Taya.
And I'm Miracle.
And we're out.
We have some announcements.
Here's Emily Cook with The Dog Dish.
Boys basketball will host Open Gym on Thursday, September 22nd and Tuesday, October 4th after school in the main gym. Any questions? See Coach Rathbun. Wait, stop! Don't throw away your broken phone, TV, or foot massager. The electronics and robotics class at room 153 can fix your electronics. Submit your request by going to the link or by texting 773-800-1781. The Richards Chess Team has begun practices on Tuesdays after school in room 206. Players of all ability and experience levels are welcome to join. See Mr. Montez or Mr. Wydra to answer any questions. Anyone who has played softball before or wants to play this spring is welcome to join in the Softball Fall Fest. The fest will take place on our fabulous softball field on the following Thursdays, September 15th, 22nd, 29th, and October 6th, from 3:30 to 5:30 p.m. Email Coach Folliard with any questions.
One of our fall sports is currently dominating on the court.
We want to take the time to appreciate the girls' tennis team.
We're passing this over to Maya with more on their exciting accomplishments.
Last Tuesday, our Richards tennis team played in their fifth match of the season against TF North. I had the pleasure of chatting with Coach Reynolds and senior tennis superstar Megan McSweeney about the match.
My name is Connor Reynolds. I'm a paraprofessional and a tennis and speech coach.
Coach Reynolds discusses the feelings of excitement at the possibility of taking the team to state for a second year in a row.
I mean, I'm always excited for it. We've been lucky enough that I've gotten to go a few times, so maybe at this point I kind of know what I'm doing.
Coach Reynolds also expresses his feelings about star player Megan McSweeney's graduation.
It's going to be sad. As I've said a few times now, once she's gone, I'm going to have to learn how to coach because she's made it really easy with lineups and just with winning.
I'm Megan McSweeney and I'm first singles.
We also spoke to Megan herself about her feelings regarding state and her personal achievements.
It's very awesome. It's a really cool feeling. I've worked really hard, so it's really cool to see that pay off.
Megan has a few goals for herself and the team this year.
My goal, obviously, is to win conference not only individually but as a team, and I'd really like to see our team do well at sectionals as well.
Megan's feelings about graduating this year and leaving the team behind are mixed.
It's really cool. I've been doing this for a long time, as you said, so it's really weird that it's my fourth in last year.
Coach Reynolds discusses some of the team's other achievements and rising stars.
We've got the kind of rise of two new players in the last couple of years. We've got Mia and Violet. Mia was kind of an out-of-nowhere conference champion last year. And then Violet's part of our number one doubles team, who also has a really good chance to do well at sectional, with Julie Casey as the senior leader in there.
And of course, we can't forget about Megan's astonishing record.
What she's done, I mean, I don't know if she's ever lost a regular season conference match, and if you extend it out to even tournament play, maybe one or two losses all the way there, it's really an amazing record.
For Bulldog Dispatch, this is Maya Garcia.
Thank you for watching Bulldog Dispatch with us.
Tune in next week to see more of the school's clubs and activities.
Once again, this is Rachel Haynes.
And this is Layla Guerrero.
And this is Bulldog Dispatch. See you later.